In this video, I'm going to explain how to solder. The first thing you're going to want to do is go into your microcade kit and grab the second smaller board, as this has the soldering iron practice board. And that's what we're going to use to practice all of our solder joints. Now, you'll also find some little pins or connectors that we're actually going to solder inside the box. These look something like that.
The next thing we need to do is plug in the soldering iron. So the first thing you want to do is put the barrel connector into the end of the soldering iron and then plug your soldering iron into a power bank or the main socket like so. Take off the protective cap, turn the soldering iron on by clicking the silver button, and you'll see a blue LED will turn on, which shows that the soldering iron is on. So currently it is heating up. It should take around 20 to 30 seconds to heat up. Now, once you're finished with the soldering iron, go ahead and turn that soldering iron off by clicking the button. And what's really ideal is to let the soldering iron cool down. As you can see, I'm letting it cool down on the stand as I don't want to burn any of the surfaces. Once it's fully cooled down, we can put the protective cap back on, unplug it, and repack it into our kit if we wish. So now we want to set up our workspace. For me, this is putting our soldering mat, but for you, you want to pick a surface that you don't mind damaging, because as we're soldering, the high heat temperature, your soldering iron may fall and it could burn the table, etc. So for me, putting a soldering mat, for you, it might just be a table that your parents will let you damage. Now we want to get our soldering iron switched on as done before, and as you can see, the blue light indicates that it is heating up, so I'm just letting it heat up while we set it up. Here we've got our solder, we've got all the header pins, and we've got the second panel in which we've got the practice soldering board that we're going to go ahead and snap off. To snap it off, you just want to use your two thumbs to just pinch it slightly and twist it to snap it like so. Do this for both joints, and then once we're finished, we can put panel two to the side and keep the practice soldering board. So now we want to grab the header pins and the practice soldering board, and you can see that the header pins have a longer side to it. So flip the soldering board over, push the pins through so the longer side is poking through, and now we're ready to start soldering. You'll also notice that there's a diagram on the board of the perfect solder joint, which shows the shiny with a volcano-like shape that I'll go into more detail about in a bit. Before we can start soldering these joints, we need to prep the soldering iron. So the first thing I'm going to do is what's called tinning the tip, where we put a little bit of solder on the end of the soldering iron, and this just primes the iron ready for when we do the actual soldering and apply the soldering iron tip onto the pin. The key to a good solder joint is to apply the end of the soldering iron between the pin and the pad, which is the little shiny circle on the PCB. Apply a little bit of solder, count for 1-2 seconds, and then release the soldering iron like so. So let's try that again. Apply the soldering iron onto the pin and the pad, hold it down for 1-2 seconds, and then with the solder, apply it to the soldering iron like so, and then release. Move on, apply, release. The aim is to create three consistent solder joints, and then you can be able to move on and solder the microcade kit.
Whew, that was pretty intense. So now we've done a perfect solder joint, let's figure out what maybe a bad or poorer solder joint looks like and how we can actually fix it. Because we're learning to solder here, we're probably going to make some mistakes, so we want to figure out how to actually identify them and solve them. So let's dive right back in.
The first solder mistake I'm going to show you is what's called bridging. Here, you can see the two pins are accidentally connected via solder. The way to solve this issue is to firstly clean the soldering iron tip. You can do this through wet foam or what I use, brass mesh. And then you want to put your soldering iron tip with no solder in between the two pins and use it to divide. So you want to drag the solder away. And there you can see the bridge has now disappeared. We want to once more clean the tip of our soldering iron, and now we have fixed it. The next solder mistake happens when you put the soldering iron on the PCB for way too long and end up burning it. The major indications is black charring of the PCB and when the solder goes from a shiny silver to a dull grey like this. Unfortunately, there's not much we can do about the black charred PCB, however, we can reflow the solder joint meaning reapplying heat to the solder joint through applying the soldering iron onto it and a little bit of extra solder just to make sure the joint is solidified. The main takeaway from this is that you can't really fix a black charred solder joint, so the ultimate goal is to make sure that never happens. So do not apply your soldering iron onto the PCB or pin for too long.
So now you know what a good solder joint looks like and you can identify and fix a bad solder joint, now you want to go ahead and solder in the rest of the pins on the solder practice board until you get a perfect solder joint 3 times in a row, and then you should feel confident enough to move on and focus and actually solder the actual microcade kit. So once you've done that, hey, hop on to the next video and we'll actually get started making the microcade.